We all had been in situations when we needed to perform in order to improve our lot in life, be it taking an exam, attending a job interview, asking someone out on a date, or giving a speech in front of an audience. And most of us felt this light tingle of anxiety before the performance. And many of us can attest that a little bit of anxiety is even beneficial for our performance, because it keeps us on the edge, keeps you focused. If you're nervous, that means that you care. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you might have already guessed, I'm not going to talk about this kind of anxiety. I'm going to talk about the cases when anxiety becomes overwhelming, when it sends you over the edge and it hinders your ability to perform. And first of all, I'd like to say that performance anxiety is a state of the mind. And when our mind enters a certain state, our body tends to react in a certain way. I'd like to introduce you to the most common symptoms of performance anxiety. Those are hyperventilation, which is a rapid and shallow breathing, tenseness in the muscles, especially in the shoulder and neck area, lack of strength in the muscles, this is when our legs and hands are trembling, overt sweating, specifically the sweating of the palms, which is a telltale sign of the nervousness, nausea, dizziness, and racing or intrusive thoughts. Those thoughts are generally of a self-destructive or self-deprecating nature. Or in my case, it was always about repeating my material that I'm about to deliver over and over and over again, like a broken record. The thing about these symptoms is that they have a lot in common with another state of mind that is very unpleasant: panic. And indeed, performance anxiety is a form of panic attack. Our body becomes a lot agitated, and we experience what is called a fight or flight response. It is as if our mind perceives the situation in front of us as dangerous and tells our body that this will be a very good time to run the hell away from here. But this would have been useful if we were walking down a dark alley and so a couple or a dozen working class guys giving us very interested looks. But when we are on the stage, we're not actually in any physical danger. Well, unless the ceiling will fall on your head, like it happened in Yemen recently. So that's why we public speakers tend to move around the stage a bit, so not to become an easy target. So why does our brain think that we are in danger? To understand that, we need to understand the underlying fears that fuel the performance anxiety. And those fears are, first of all, it's the fear of failure. And if we were to analyze a bit further, then what results from failure, that would be public humiliation. And the thing that comes after public humiliation inevitably is loss of social status. Human beings are social animals, and our societies tend to be very hierarchical in nature. And whoever is on top lives in a far better condition than whoever is below him. With advance of the progress, it allowed for the upwards movement within the hierarchy, so the structure is not so rigid. And we have a lot more opportunities to advance our stature than our ancestors did. But our brains still associate our social status with our well-being. Those two concepts are linked on a very base level. And when we face the situation that would result in loss of social status, then our mind interprets it as a threat to our well-being. And if we to analyze different situations in which performance anxiety arises, then all of these three fears will be present in some way. If we fail an exam, then that means we will lose our scholarship. That means that our financial situation will decrease. If we fail at taking a driving test, for example, then that means we are not allowed to own ride a car, which is, car in turn is a status symbol. If we fail asking someone out on a date, which it's not only humiliating, then that means we will stay single. And if you're single and young, then society thinks that there's something really wrong with you. When it comes to public speaking, fear of public speaking is the number one phobia in the world, precisely because the threat of public humiliation and loss of social status are looming over you when you step up to the microphone. But the good part about performance anxiety is that, yes, while our mind tells our body what to do, body and mind relations are actually a two-way street. If we take care of the body, then our mind can enter a state in which we can perform better. And the best part about performance anxiety is that our brains are very robust. The more you perform, the less anxiety becomes an issue. But that's going beyond the topic of my speech. Thank you very much.